Hello everyone, this week's second wave of winter weather is upon us and we are tracking some reasonably heavy snow this afternoon. Still snowing in Helena, but not all that heavy. You definitely got some flurries moving across our opportunity bank. ICAM definitely snow still on the roads. Doesn't look like a ton there. But look at Great Falls. Great Falls looks much worse right now. We've got some heavy snow currently falling. I'm recording this just before about 3 p.m. and we are seeing that snow continuing to fall in Great Falls. Reduced visibility, lots of snow on the roads. Here's what that snow looks like on the Doppler network. As is often the case, we're not picking up on that light snow over toward Helena, but we've definitely got that heavier band set up across Great Falls and extends all the way off to the northeast toward even Phillips County and even Northern Valley County, where we're seeing some additional snow. So that has left roads slippery, or continued to make roads slippery is maybe the better way to say that. Not severe driving conditions. We're not seeing the blowing and drifting as bad as we were earlier in the week, but we definitely have snow-covered roads. At this point, from about Shelby over to Chester is reported as okay, but I imagine those roads are going to be getting slippery pretty soon, if not already. So roads are definitely impacted, definitely getting slippery here this afternoon, and we're going to continue to see snow through the evening. We'll probably lighten up a little bit as we head into the early evening hours, but we are expecting another heavier wave of snow to move in as we head toward about 10 p.m. to midnight, and that'll last into tomorrow morning. By about 8 a.m., 6 a.m. tomorrow, a lot of this is really starting to break apart. The heaviest snow is going to be falling mostly overnight. After sunrise won't be too bad, with the exception of southeast Montana. By about noon, most of us are done with the snow, so there is an end in sight. And definitely as we head into Saturday night, we're pretty much finished up with that snow, and we actually start to get some clearing sky. So we have made some changes to the snowfall forecast here. Going about 5 to 8 for Lewistown, so that's a tiny bit lower than what we were thinking yesterday, about 5 to 8 for Great Falls. The biggest changes over in eastern Montana, actually, only 2 to 4 for Glasgow and Jordan. We've seen the models really take the snow down in that area, but still accumulating snow for pretty much everybody. And of course, with snow falling as heavily as it currently is, there are going to be some travel impacts. Let's talk wind as well, because it's really not going to be a huge factor. Definitely enough of a breeze for some blowing and drifting, especially given how light and fluffy this snow is. But the strongest winds are going to be mostly away from our area. Again, it's southeastern Montana. Our current wind speeds, most of us are less than 10 miles per hour. It is a little breezier off to the east. Jordan, Glasgow, you guys are looking at some actually fairly strong winds. And with those stronger winds, though, it definitely feels cold out there. It feels like 4 below right now in Cutbank and also Great Falls, a little bit better where it's warmer off to the east. Actual air temperatures, single digits for many of us. Again, a little bit warmer in eastern Montana. They're looking at temperatures that are mainly in the 20s. As far as low temperatures tonight, going to be getting pretty chilly, falling right about down to 0 in Great Falls, 3 for Helena. Some of us staying as warm as the 20s. Pretty chilly again on Saturday. Again, we do get a little bit of sunshine to help us out later in the day, but definitely cooler than average. So good news, bad news here. We've had a lot of bad news in the forecast. Continue to track snow through the night tonight and even into early tomorrow. But then